restoration to my soul. Good morning, our viewers at home, and welcome you again to this wonderful time with the Lord. Restoration today. This is the place where God is restoring everything into your life. Good things, wonderful things, glorious things, beautiful things. The Lord is restoring into your house, into your life, to your house, to everything that concerns you. So I'm welcoming you back to this, our time with the Lord, restoration today. Before we continue, shall we give praise to the Lord through prayers? Jesus, we thank you this morning. We appreciate you for this great grace and wonderful privilege given unto us to have slept and woke up back peacefully this morning. Thank you for the day. Thank you, glorious Father. Thank you for the night. Thank you for everything. May your name be glorified, O Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray that you forgive us our sins. Lord, we pray, God, as we go to this time to listen to your word, this very short time, Lord, we pray that you minister unto our lives. So, God, take glory of the life of the viewers at home to the glory of your name. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. I'm welcoming you to this wonderful day. Today is October 4th, and today we are celebrating Nigeria. Nigeria is 59 today. Happy celebration, Nigeria. Happy independence anniversary. I pray that the Lord himself will continue to keep us great in this nation. The nation will be back stronger and stronger in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Things shall get better as far as this nation is concerned. And I pray this 1 year shall be glorious, shall be fulfilling years for everyone. And I pray that everyone, majority of us in Nigeria, shall move closer unto Christ. The Lord himself will continue to minister to us. This year shall be a year of exaltation, shall be a year of glorious things in this nation in the name of Jesus Christ. And we pray again for the government of this nation, that the government, the Lord will keep helping them, who are stronger. The glory of the Lord will shine upon them, and I pray that the Lord will lead them to lead us right in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm welcoming you again to this episode of Restoration Today. I pray greater things shall be restored into your lives, better things, glorious and beautiful things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Today, what you have for us today, October 1st, righteousness exalts a nation. Righteousness exalts a nation. I want to tell you that there's nothing better than righteousness exalting a nation. Any nation that is righteous will, of course, be exalted. The Lord is in the work of exalting people. But who are those that exalt? He is in the work of exalting those that are righteous. So the question is, are we righteous? If Nigeria is righteous enough, the Lord is faithful to exalt Nigeria. And I pray that Nigeria be exalted in the name of Jesus. In this 1 year, there will be glorious exaltation as far as this nation is concerned in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Our Bible text for today is Proverbs chapter 11, verse 11. Proverbs 11, 11. The Bible says, and I read, by the blessing of the upright, the city is exalted, but it is overthrown by the mouth of the wicked. I pray that Nigeria will never be overthrown in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Again, I am praying that your home, your life, your ministry, your work will never be overthrown. Every good thing in your life will never be overthrown in the name of Jesus Christ. And I pray that God's exaltation shall visit you in Jesus' name. Christianity is a call to righteousness and holiness. Yes, this we must know. And these are the two key things that Christianity is all about. A call unto righteousness and a call unto holiness. At new birth, the seed of righteousness is divinely planted into you. And you have equally been endowed with power to live up to the standard of God. Yes, you must know this, that at the point when you became born again, at the point when Christ Jesus meets you, at the point when you have your new birth, something is sown in your life. And what is that that is sown? The seed of righteousness is divinely planted into your life. God himself will plant into your life. And I want you to know that each time that every person comes to Christ, there is something in him. The person will always want to run away from sin. It means at that point in time, something has been planted into the life of that person. You know, that is why you behave well and always thirsty and hungry for righteousness and holiness at new birth. Why? Because at that point, righteousness, living a righteous life, is planted into your life. The seed of holiness is planted into your life. And at a new point where those things are planted in the life, as they are coming up, they come up fresh. And you see that every person that is being born again, every person that got close to Christ at that point in time always wants to behave like Christ. They are always cautious of themselves. They are always running away from sin because at that point
of new creation, at that point of new birth, something is planted into their life. And what is that? It is the seed of righteousness and holiness. You see that such people, they begin to run after righteousness. They begin to be hungry and be thirsty for holiness. Everything that concerns them is all about Christ. They run away from sin. They flee away from sin. But I want to tell you that even at that, at the point in time, something happens into the life of man. What is that? Satan will come in and begin to plant some unwanted things, some tears into the weeds that have been planted into one's life. And that is where every Christian ought to be very, very careful. For you as a believer, to experience genuine lifting in your field, to endeavor at all times, you need to continue submitting to the righteousness of God and not to your own righteousness. And this is what you needed. So at the point in time when you became born again, at the point in time when that seed of righteousness and holiness is planted into your life, what you need to do as Christian is to keep submitting yourself. You keep putting yourself under the control of the Almighty God. You begin to live under God's righteousness and not your own righteousness. You begin to run away from the righteousness of the law, because there's nothing that the law can do unto you. But Christ himself is the only one that can give you the power for righteousness, that can give you the power unto holiness. I pray today that the power and the grace to continue running after righteousness and living a holy life, may the Lord endow unto you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I am reading from the book of Romans chapter 10, verses 3 and 4. Romans chapter 10, verses 3 and 4. The Bible says, "For they, being ignorant of God's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God." So by the time you begin to run after your own righteousness or the righteousness of the law, you are keeping yourself away from the righteousness of God. And once you must know that there is no way you can be righteous except you depend on God, except you submit yourself under the control of God the Almighty. He's the one that has the power to make you to be righteous. He's the one that has the power to make you to be thirsty and hungry for holiness. Because at new birth, don't forget what we said, that at new birth, something is planted into your life. That is the seed of righteousness and the seed of holiness. By the time you allow Christ to grow in you, you allow him to begin to water those seeds that have been planted into your life. You begin to grow more and more. And the more you grow, the more you come to know him. The more you grow, the more you begin to see him, to see that light of righteousness and holiness shining into your life. I'm reading verse 4 of Romans chapter 10. "For Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone that believeth." So the one that can give you that power unto righteousness is Christ. Christ is the end of the law for righteousness, not just to anyone, but to everyone that believes. So I want to enjoy you this morning that you need to have that faith in Christ, that you need to believe in him. By the time you do that, he will give you that power unto righteousness. The question is even this: what is this righteousness that we are talking about? How can one be righteous? Righteousness simply means having a right standing with God. That is, you stand for God. You stand by God. You stand with God. Everything you do it in God. Righteousness also means a total submission, obedience, and faith unto God. Just like Abraham, the Bible said Abraham had faith in God and it was counted unto him as righteousness. So we need to have faith in God. We need to believe in God. We need to submit everything in totality unto God. And by the time we do this, yes, we are pursuing righteousness. You empty yourself. You begin to see Christ. You begin to see God as the one that is sufficient for you in everything. You see yourself that you cannot do anything on your own. There's no power of your own. There's no way you can run on your own. There's no way you can achieve anything on your own. Whatever you want to become, whatever you want to achieve, anything you want to do, you depend on God himself. You submit yourself unto God. Abraham submitted himself unto God. He gave all unto God. He had that faith in God. And the Bible said it was counted unto him as righteousness. He lived a righteous life because he submitted. He had that faith in God. Whatever God wanted him to do, he gave all and he did it unto God. Even when there was no hope for him again, he submitted. He gave himself unto God, unto Christ. I pray this morning that the power to have ourselves committed, submitted unto God, may the Lord grant unto you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So again, as nation is concerned, no nation, no family, no firm, religious organization or individual can excel in their day-to-day activities above their level of righteousness. This you must know, that the more righteous you are, the more excellent you become. The more righteous you are, the more you'll be exalted. Because Christ, the eyes of God, will always be on those that are righteous. Because each time you are righteous, you are always running away from sin. And whoever runs away from sin will definitely be closer unto Christ. So there's no way you can live above your righteousness. There's no way you can do above your righteousness. Even a nation can never rise above its righteousness. So any nation that exalts sin will be at a low level. I pray for Nigeria that the power to exalt righteousness may the Lord give unto us as a nation in the name of Jesus Christ. Because today we are celebrating Nigeria at 59. And I must tell you, if Nigeria must rise up again, if Nigeria will be exalted, if Nigeria will go far, we need to exalt righteousness. We need to take away lies and deceptive things as far as this nation is concerned. I pray that God will lead our leaders to live a righteous life, that this nation may be exalted and all may be a partaker of good things as far as this nation is concerned, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is holy, righteous, and just, which is the reason why God wants us to be righteous, because He Himself is a righteous person. He Himself is just. He is a holy being. And as far as that is concerned, He always wants us to do that. Except we are holy, we are just and righteous, there's no way we can walk side by side with God. And He demands same from His sons and daughters, for them to be exalted. So He demands even the same from us as a nation. He demands the same from us as individuals. He demands the same from us as family. He demands the same from us even as church. Church also needs to exalt righteousness. Church also needs to preach righteousness. Pastors, ministers of God, every year, near and near, we need to preach righteousness. We need to exalt righteousness. Our attitude, everything about us, need to speak righteousness. Sin has nothing to offer other than demotion and destruction, which is why God wants us not to embrace it. This you must know, that the only thing that sin does is to bring down one. And any nation that exalts him will definitely be brought down. Israel prospers when they are righteous unto God. Each time that Israel was, as a nation, was walking with the Lord, you will see that God was always exalting them. Take for example what happened in the book of Judges. Each time that these people were righteous, the Lord will always exalt them. Each time they were doing things that were okay, that were good unto God, pleasant unto God, God was always exalting them. God was always being their God. He was always fighting for them. But at the point in time when they rejected God, God will bring a nation that will come to punish them. I pray that Nigeria as a nation will never be punished in the name of Jesus. But this will only come to be provided we are exalting righteousness. The Israelites in the book of Judges, the Bible says they will live up to the standard of God and they will prosper. But at the point in time when they begin to move away from God, when they begin to worship gods like Baal, like Asherah, and what have you, God will be annoyed unto them. He will bring a nation. In fact, He will bring a smaller nation, a nation that is not as big as they are, a nation that is not as strong as they are, to begin to afflict them. Why? Because they neglected God. Because they exalted sin. And don't forget what we said, that you cannot live above your righteousness. So they were brought low. They were being tormented. They were being afflicted. I pray that Nigeria will never be tormented and afflicted in the name of Jesus. And anywhere there's affliction from any part of the nation, I pray that the Lord Himself will fight for us in the name of Jesus. But what we need to do as a nation, what we need to do as individual, it starts with an individual. We need to exalt righteousness. We need to preach righteousness. We need to move around with righteousness. Everything we do must be in a righteous form. We need to be holy. Take away deceptives, take away lies. And if this can be done, as far as this nation is concerned, the Lord will be with us and will continue to exalt us, because righteousness exalts a nation. And the one who is at the work of exalting a nation is God. But behold, this can never be except if we are righteous, we are holy, and we are just. And these are the requirements from God from us. It is therefore expedient for you to cultivate the habit of righteousness daily, that you may live to see what will become of you in the nearest future. For you to have a better future, What you need to do is to cultivate the habit of righteousness, is to begin to live a life that is full of righteousness. If this is done by you, then know that you are having a brighter future. Know that you are having a glorious future. Even if you are facing any challenges today, even if anything come before you, but be sure that you will be exalted. Be sure that God will make a way for you. Be sure, rest assured, that very good things will come your way in the nearest future. I pray you will not fail or fall prey to defeat in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is the one that exalts. And one of the keys to having this done is for us to be righteous. What is the state of Nigeria today? It all starts with every person beside you. So what we are saying is that you must start that righteousness even with the least person beside you. Be faithful to the person beside you. In the little thing you are doing, in the slightest thing you are doing, in the firm where you find yourself, the organization where you find yourself, in the church where you find yourself, even among your family, even between a husband and the wife, there must be that righteous path, righteous living, living out of deceptive. I pray the Lord will help us with this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let's begin to exalt righteousness in all form. Let's begin to exalt righteousness in all ways. Let's begin to exalt righteousness anywhere we find ourselves. Let's begin to exalt righteousness in every organization that we find ourselves. Begin to promote it. And as we do that, you begin to see that you begin to affect the life of the person beside you. If A is righteous, B is righteous, C is righteous, even to Z, I want to tell you that exhortation will definitely become ours. And we need to start praying even for our leaders as far as this nation is concerned to be righteous. Our leaders in their different categories, they also need to embrace righteousness. And if this is done, I want to bet you that Nigeria will be exalted again. Things will be getting better as far as this nation is concerned. The Lord begin to prosper this nation. Things begin to get well. Our seasons begin to come at due time. I pray the Lord himself will give us the power to be righteous in the name of Jesus. And our government in their respective categories, in their different categories, in their ranks, I pray the Lord will help each of them to be righteous in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. What is the action point for today? Living a life of righteousness is not optional. Yes, living a life of righteousness is not an option. It's something that must be done. It is principal. It is mandatory. It is ultimate requirement for you lifting. Embrace righteousness and you'll be exalted. What are the scriptural passages for today? We have Proverbs chapter 14 verse 34 as well as 1 Peter 2, 15 to 16. I pray today the Lord himself will cause you to be righteous in all ramifications in the name of Jesus Christ. And as you do that, I want to tell you that God is in the work of exalting you. He will keep exalting you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you in Jesus' name. Shall we pray? Lord Jesus, we thank you for this special and glorious morning, this morning of independence and celebration, independence anniversary for Nigeria. Thank you because Nigeria is 59 years old today. I will know that the nation will be going better and growing better and stronger in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, Lord, we pray that as far as this nation is concerned, you help us to exalt nothing but righteousness, that this nation may be exalted. Give us the grace to promote righteousness in every area, in every form, in every firm, every organization, anywhere we find ourselves, starting with individual to the person nearest unto us, to our people at home, to different ones, Lord, we pray that you give Nigeria, give every individual the power and the grace to exalt righteousness in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we pray, as this is done, in your faithfulness, O Lord, you begin to exalt us as a nation, exalt us as individual, exalt us, O God, as organizations in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we pray, O God, that you give us the grace to measure up to standard of righteousness. Father, deliver us, O God, from sin that easily beset and from presumptuous sins in the name of Jesus Christ. And Father, Lord, we pray that you help us all to allow our destiny not to be damaged in the name of Jesus Christ because of secret sin in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Be with us, O Lord. And I pray for the viewers at home. As they step out this morning, they will step out into glory. They will step into greatness, into joy, into upliftment, into breakthrough in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will make a way for you. As you are going out, you shall come back home peacefully. The Lord will go out with you and be with you and bring you back home safely in the name of Jesus. It shall be well with you in Jesus' name. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen and amen. God bless you. Remain blessed in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is well with you in Jesus' name. Amen.
You bring restoration. Would you bring restoration? You bring restoration.